Dear friends, we are going to start Java first lecture. In this lecture, we are going to study about Java, the basic of Java. So basic of Java, we are going to study in four parts. That evolution and creation of Java. Second is impact of Java on internet. Third one is the difference between the JVM, JRE and JDK. And the fourth one is bytecode. What is a bytecode? So without wasting time, let's start. First of all, we should know what is Java. Java is a programming language like C++, which provides us object-oriented features. So now, student who don't know about object-oriented features, I'll explain it later. So basically, object-oriented features has a set of defined features like encapsulation, abstraction, inheritance. We will discuss it later on further lectures. So first we'll go to the creation of Java. So when it was originated? So basically it was originated in 1991. And the first time when Java was created, it was created by some 5 developers at Sun Microsystem in 1991. And that Java was named as Oak System, right? So later on, it took around 2 to 3 years to stable that version, first version of that Java. And in 1995, this Oak, which was Java, initially Java, the name Java was not initially formed. It was Oak. So it was not very famous. So in 1995, it was renamed as Java. And Java is basically a name of island. Thereafter, that version 1.1 was released. So we will ask, what is the motivation behind the Java creation? If we have already C++ language with us, why we created Java? So basically there are two primary motivation. People who understand that primary motivation was internet, that's not true. That primary motivation for the Java creation was the system portability. System portability, you may say platform independency. How it is platform independent? What do you mean by platform? So platform means, those who don't know, platform means operating system. So not only operating system, it could be operating system plus let's not go in much detail. For the time being, you just understand it is just platform. When we say it is operating system, so it is platform independent. So how it is platform independent? So when you run this program of Java in Windows, you can run in Windows also and you can run in Linux also. So you will ask that C++ can also do the same. But remember, for the C++ you need to build again for the Linux, again for the Windows. So if you're trying to build the version which is built on Windows, cannot be run on Linux platform. But in case of Java, we should not worry about whether it is built on Java, whether it is built on Windows or it is built on Linux. So that's why it is platform independent. So that was the primary motivation behind the creation of Java. Now what is the secondary motivation? As we already discussed, that internet, yes, during 90s, the internet was coming into the picture. So people want some features which needs to be platform independent also, plus some exciting features which can be integrated with the browser so that people can do the internet surfing and downloading whatever. So for that motivation, There is a feature in Java that is applet. Okay. So applet is a Java program. It is designed to be transmitted over the internet, and when operator clicks any of the features inside the web browser, it downloads at the client side, and that applet will run at the client side. So what I mean, we have World Wide Web, right? There is a client sitting over here. Okay, the client is requesting some data. That data is provided by the internet, and that feature, this data is nothing but applet, and this applet will run at the client side. Okay, so this applet will execute here and do whatever the features he wants, the client wants, right? So that's why that this motivation, secondary motivation, I'll explain applet in much detail. You just know that there is feature called applet in Java, which was the secondary motivation for the Java creation. So applet runs on the client side. You just remember it. So secondary is what goes behind the security and portability. So security, if we talk about security and portability, if we talk about applet, so anybody who is requesting from World Wide Web, that virus or Trojan horses or malicious content can be transmitted over the internet and sent to the client side, and the internet browser which client has, that can execute this applet which may contain that malicious content, then the system get affected, this client get affected. So security was a breaching factor. Portability, of course, when there was no Java, the portability was a factor. So you will say, how these two characteristics is resolved in Java. So basically these two are resolved using JVM. Now let's talk about what is JVM. Okay, let me just give a brief about this JVM, then we will discuss JVM much in detail here. So JVM is nothing but it is Java Virtual Machine, which is a Java program, and it is responsible for executing the code, and the code is provided by the Java language. So you have a Java Virtual Machine on Windows. By this you can run your code. Okay, there is a concept called JRE also, I'll explain. So it is on Windows platform. So JVM, if it is built on Windows platform, that JVM is installed on a Windows platform, and JVM installed on a Linux platform. So one thing has to be remembered, that JVM itself, it is not platform independent. JVM program, that you should know that initially it was with the Sun Microsystem. Nowadays it is with Oracle. Okay, so from JDK 7, Oracle has bought this Sun Microsystem, so that everything is now managed by the Oracle. Okay, so now JVM on Windows and JVM on Linux, these two are platform dependent. So JVM is built for the Windows, this JVM is built for the Linux. But for the Java code which we built, we don't require separately to be built for Windows, separately to be Linux. I'll show you the program and build, and then we will run. You will see the code which is built on Linux, it is also running in the Windows without compiling again. Okay, so it is a Java virtual machine. Okay, where are we? Yes, security input. Yes, so JVM, inside JVM we have compiler called JIT. It's not a compiler, it's a software JIT. Actually compiler is Java C. So in JIT it is just in time. Just in time compiler, what it does, it is compile only those portion which is actually required. So not compiling, actually it is interpreted. Let me explain. In case of Java, you first create the source code. Remember, whenever you want to create a class, the class name and the file name should be the same. I'll discuss it later also. So everything in this lecture we'll discuss much in detail in further lectures. So hello.java, let's suppose the class name is hello.java. Now this hello.java, it moves into a system. Now this hello.java is basically developed using Java Development Kit, right? So inside Java Development Kit, we have Java compiler.exe, right? So this Java compiler, what it does, it generates a dot class file. Now here is the interesting part. This dot class file is not the binary code, it is not the machine code, rather it is actually byte code. Interesting, right? What is byte code? So byte code is an intermediate form which can be converted into machine code only by the language provider, right? So who is the language provider here? So language provider is the same who is giving that compiler, right? So we have a JVM here, right? Now JVM during runtime, what it does, it uses this JIT compiler. Okay, so hello.class, we have a byte code here, so it get loaded and it run in this Java virtual machine using java.exe. so JVM, let us suppose this is for Windows JVM, so we have a JIT compiler here. What JIT compiler does, it is a just-in-time compiler. The piece which you want to require to execute, what it does, it takes from that class and it gets built in. So that hello.class, it converts into that platform specific. This platform is Windows, so it will convert into that platform specific and execute that machine code, right? So bytecode is an intermediate form which will be converted again to the executable machine code only when it is required, and this can be done by the JIT compiler, right? So you can see this JVM itself is controlling which code has to be executed, and if there is any code, any problem, any security related issues, that can be prompted by this JVM itself, right? That's why Java is a good programming language for the World Wide Web, that is internet, because of the security and portability features. I must also tell you, the Java has many features, not called so many features, it is the characteristics of the Java. Like, it is simple programming language, it is secure programming language, it is portable, object-oriented of course, multi-threaded, it's a robust, dynamic, distributed, it is interpreted also. So Java has very beautiful features. right? So we understand what is bytecode. Byte is an code is an intermediate form. Like in C++, what we generate .exe, right? That is the final one is the exe, which is machine code. In case of Java, the compiler, what it generates the bytecode. Now let us understand what this JVM, JRE and JDK. This JVM, it is a Java virtual machine. So in Java virtual machine, when you include the library set, the combination of this JVM and the some library set is known as JRE. Right? JRE is Java Runtime Environment. Okay. Java Runtime Environment is a combination of JVM, Java Virtual Machine, which we have already know what is Java Virtual Machine, and some library set. That library set is basically it is required to load the libraries, to load the classes, to link the classes. We'll discuss the JVM architecture in much detail. Okay, so this entire it is called as a Java Runtime Environment. Now, this JRE itself, when it is included along with some tools for the development like IDE, right? IDE is like what? Editor. It is Integrated Development Environment. In Integrated Development Environment, what is required? Editor. You require debugger. If you found any bug and you want to debug it, so it is exactly that bug. It is found by this debugger. In case of Linux, the GCC, we used to use that GDB, right? So this editor, debugger, and of course that display. All these features, editor, debugger, display, all these features are in Integrated Development Environment. So if you have a JRE with this set of tools, this entire component is called as JDK, that is Java Development Kit. Okay, now let us discuss about the servlets. So servlets are dynamically generated content. Okay, so before this, you should know there are two types of information that are transmitted over server to content. That is the active information, or you can say the dynamic information, or the passive information, or the static information. So while we say it is a active information, that is dynamically generated content, suppose I am looking at a website which gives me the total details of the employees. So I am running my machine. I don't need to put all the details at the client side. So what client does, client requests to the server, and server will provide the dynamically generated content. So the employee may be added or may be deleted. So all the details of the current employee will only be fetched through the dynamically generated content. So what servlets does, like in applet, it runs at the client side. But in case of servlet, it runs at the server side. You send a request, client send a request to the server. Server provides a web page, dynamically generated web page, through a mechanism called Common Gateway Interface, CGI, right? So that is served to the client, and then client see that result. So that is achieved by Java feature. This is one of the Java features, like applet, it is also one of the Java features, servlet. You should know that applet is phased out, that it is almost obsolete during after JDK 7, right? So now let us see what are the new features which were added in the post JDK 7. Why JDK 7? Because at that time Oracle took over that Sun Microsystem. So let's see new features. It is NIO framework, network input output framework. for the network programming. We have a fork join framework for the parallel programming. We have lambda expression. I'll discuss it later. Again, JavaFX, it is better than Swing and better than Applet, right? So we'll see JavaFX also modules. It's a very good concept, modules. We have a JLink. JLink, it gives a runtime image of your application, this JLink. It's a very good tool. Good tool, which is added. Now, the current version of the JDK is 9, and the internal version, which is it is maintained, is 1.9. I think that's all for the basic. We'll move to the programming skill in further lectures, and we will see also JVM.
Do subscribe,
like, and share also, because if you subscribe and you share, okay, you let us suppose you know all about this and you want to share this information for those who actually don't know. So this will be great help for them who actually don't know, right? So please do subscribe, share, and like. Thank you.